more energy from the sun hits the Earth every hour than humans use in a year. But if we want to up the use of that carbon-free power, we'll have to capture a lot more of it. That will take space, heaps of it. And finding space for solar arrays that doesn't sacrifice the environment or other things people care about, well, that is all science, no fiction. Every few weeks, Oregon State grad student Alyssa Andrew takes a stroll through the solar array.
This is a plate meter, so we basically just go.
It gives her the height of the grass.
You want like about 30 measurements per plot.
The ground cover is a mix of grasses, clover, and other plants that provide a delicious lunch for the solar array's current residents.
It's usually one of them will come up and either the other ones will follow or they'll just stare like, I kind of want pets, but also I don't know if I trust you.
Andrew is studying pasture growth, water use, how quickly the lambs are growing, and if the panels cause them stress.
Just from personal experience, they seem to like it better.
And some of her results comparing this kind of pasture to open fields are surprising. Around the panels, the lambs chunked up fast. Almost as fast as in the open.
Plants underneath the panels tend to have higher leaf area, so that way they can capture more sunlight. So it had better nutritional values for them.
The research is showing the untapped potential of what's been dubbed agrivoltaics.
I spend a lot of my time thinking about what I can do that's transformational, that's not just a little better, something that's gonna change the way we think.
It's thinking that will eventually help make the most out of solar projects, like this one, already underway in Southern Oregon.
We're working on something that I think can have a huge impact.
Agrivoltaics pairs agriculture and solar power production to the mutual benefit of both. Think salt and caramel, gin and tonic, ranch and, well, anything. They're better together.
Solar likes to be in places that have flat ground, plenty of sun, already ecologically disturbed, deep soils, close to an urban area, so that we have access to markets and infrastructure. I just described agricultural land.
Drive through a rural area and you've probably seen it. Farm fields that have been decommissioned and converted to solar installations. It's usually one or the other. But Higgins's research is showing ways of doing both together.
I think the key words are more food, better food, less water, extra revenue for the farm. It's a four-way win for farmers.
And it's a huge win for everyone else if it helps us stop burning fossil fuels.
The solution to climate change is rural America.
So how does all this agrivoltaic benefit happen? Well, solar panels can extend growing seasons for some crops by protecting them from frost in the winter and from the intense sun of summer.
So you can push the seasons out in both directions when it's designed right.
And while farmers would lose some plantable ground to the panels, they could make up for it by selling the energy.
A guaranteed revenue stream that you can count on every year.
But of all the benefits that agrivoltaic systems could provide, the impact on water use may be the most intriguing.
If we were a big commercial operation, we wouldn't be doing it this way, but research is a little less efficient.
Water is an issue. Our climate is getting hotter and drier. And if we want to continue to grow food and eat, that we need to look at alternatives.
Garrett studies dry farming. That's growing crops without irrigation.
This is Adirondack blue. I don't actually know what color it is on the inside. This is the first time we've grown it.
Their harvest will show if dry farming different varieties of potatoes in the shelter of solar panels gives them any added boost.
Potatoes are more shade tolerant than some other crops that love full sun, like tomatoes and squash and melons and dry beans and corn.
Agrivoltaics pairs nicely with dry farming because the panels can reduce how much precious water is lost to evaporation and transpiration. You know, plant sweat.
in the solar setting. There's definitely a not just a shading effect, but a sheltering effect from the wind as well.
And Garrett is finding some potato varieties are doing better around the panels than in full sun. But despite the promising results, agrivoltaics are not going to work for every crop and every climate. And big outstanding questions about grid access and upfront costs linger.
We don't have to make it work everywhere, right? We can pick and choose and pick the best spots. It's our universe to design.
It's a universe built on science and technology that puts rural communities at its center.
10 years from now, 20 years from now, we'll have that. We'll have the designs. It won't be a research question anymore. It'll be a reality.
And in agrivoltaics, Higgins sees a future that's bright enough to power the entire country.
Fingers crossed.
It takes a lot of beans to make All Science No Fiction and OPB's other great shows and series. Show your support for OPB by making a gift today. Thanks.